Well, good morning. How are you all doing today?
Great.
Are you ready for me to sing this morning? I've been taking lessons on drums, so I will be helping with the drums this morning too. Well, so glad to see you this morning. Can we start with a word of prayer? Heavenly Father, thank you for being with us this morning already. We've sensed your presence. Thank you for being in the service yesterday, and I pray that you'd speak to our hearts today and be with the Foresters as they bring the message of salvation to each one of us. We ask this in your name. Amen.
Amen.
Just a couple of quick announcements. First off, this afternoon we have the movie, The Hill, over across the over in Ocotillo. So please come and see that. It's a great movie. It's at 3 o'clock. 3 o'clock. Or some people do 3 o'clock. And on Friday, yeah, that's the way we do. Okay. And Friday night is the Teen Challenge Home of Hope banquet. If you have not got your tickets, please come see me. Somebody is not able to attend, and they are willing to give the tickets to somebody that would like to go. So I've got 2 tickets for Friday night that we need to do. Go see Joe and Helen, okay? Just lead me out of it, okay? And what else was, over on this table over here, we're doing a little bit of cleanup because we're gonna be changing cabinets and things like that. We're doing a little bit of cleanup, and because we have not been using the hymnals, we're singing songs out of the hymnal, but we're not using the hymnals for service. You're more than welcome to go get a hymnal and take it home with you and study it and prepare for the songs next week. We want you to have them memorized. All the songs, yes, Wayne, all the songs need to be memorized. So you're welcome to take those, okay? Amen? And then whatever's left over, we're going to take over to Oasis and probably Caliche, some of those places. Depends on how many's left. Have I missed anything? How about if I stand here and just look pretty? Bible study on Tuesday, prayer on Thursday, you know, all that stuff.
Both at 10 o'clock.
Steve, would you please walk him out the door? Okay. So later in the service, we will do a love offering. Make sure that you do love these guys, because we've had them before, and they're a great, great group, aren't they?
Yeah.
And pray for them this morning. And right now, I'll introduce to you the Foresters.
Been good to you, can you say a big amen?
Amen.
the name of Jesus this morning. Here we go.
Thank you.
It's my greatest joy in life to travel the country and play in a band with my sons. Are you glad to see these boys here today? 1,711 miles to get here today. We left the house Thursday night, got here last night, and that's 6.5 miles to the gallon, if we're lucky. It's $1,114 in fuel, if you care. But we've come for two reasons. One is to tell you there's a Savior named Jesus. If you don't know Him as your Savior, the Bible says confess your sins and you'll be forgiven. The second is to let you know that the God of Gideon can do the impossible. Whatever you're walking through, whatever storm you're carrying, He is there with you. Amen?
Amen.
If we can leave here with those two things in our hearts, solidified, remembered, then it's worth every mile. I love this song.
Only here, far away, stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love
service time is what it was. Whenever the service time was picked years ago, it was Methodists that chose it, I can tell you that. Because Methodists like to have that early service, and then get to the restaurant before the Baptists. And so, but don't worry, us Baptists, we've timed it out that we get there before the Pentecostals ever think about it. So, works out. How many of you have never heard our family before? This is your first time ever hearing us. How many of you? Well, there's a bunch of you scattered around. Good. I think the first time we came was in 2020, wasn't it? I believe so, yeah. So this is our fifth time coming, and it's always good. And it's our first stop. We're doing 12 concerts in 13 days. That's what we said. But we're here in Arizona. So tonight we're in Sun City, or this afternoon we're in Sun City. Tomorrow night we're in, where are we at tomorrow? Yuma. I don't remember where we are Tuesday morning, but we're somewhere. I think it's Tempe. It's Tuesday morning. I can't remember. But, and then, so anyways, just on and on and on. Then we go to New Mexico, out to the Navajo Reservation, do four Navajo churches out there. It's going to be awesome. We love doing that every year. But we are the Foresters. We live in Nashville, Tennessee, and home of Honky Tonk and Yeehaw, you know? So, but we left, like I said, we left in the night. We got here, and we're still not really sure what time it is or who we are, but we got here just fine, and everything ran good, and praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And it was a pretty good trip, other than all of a sudden in Oklahoma. Oklahoma wanted to blow us off the road. Oklahoma said, you are not going to stay on the road in your motorhome, are you? But the wind blew like crazy. But we made it. My name is Mark. I started traveling. I just finished my 30th year traveling and singing gospel music. And that's a few, isn't it? You know, some people say that's a career, that when you hit 30 years, you can retire. And get a gold watch if you had a real good job. I sing gospel music. The only gold watch I'm getting is if I win it in the claw machine at Cracker Barrel, you know. So, but I started traveling 30 years ago, and I sang when I started. I was 17, and I sang with a group called Freely Given. That's me over in the corner, if you can believe that. I know time has not been friendly. All right. But that's what happens to most of us, okay? None of you, of course, but just me. But I sang with this group for about a year, and then the group split up, and I started doing solo work, and very quickly, I was doing 150, then 200 concerts a year, and then I remember one year, I think it was 1997, I did 287 concerts by myself as a soloist. That's crazy. And then one day, one of those solo concerts brought me to a little town called Bardstown, Kentucky. You're looking at the whole town. And I showed up at this little church, didn't know a single person there, and a man walked up to me and he said his name was Joe. He was an evangelist. He said, "Hey, I had the Sunday off. I came to hear you sing. This is my home church." He says, "How about?" He said, I think we should go to lunch." I didn't know him. I was like 20 years old. I didn't really want to go, you know, with a stranger, but he was going to pay for it, so I knew God wanted me to go. So I went with him, and man, I'm glad I did, because that day at the buffet, I met his daughter, and she fell madly in love with me at the buffet that afternoon. She relentlessly chased me for 10 months, and 10 months, oh, you can laugh, but 10 months after we met, we were married, all right? And that's been almost 24 years. Would you welcome Andrea, all right? Andrea grew up on the road, sing with her family. Her dad was a preacher, and her mom and dad and her brother and sister, they traveled, and they would do revivals and tent meetings and all kinds of things, and her family would sing, and her dad would preach, and so she did that her entire life up until we got married, right up until the week we got married. We got married, and then we got back from our honeymoon on a Saturday. And the next day, we sang in two different churches. That's literally how we started. And so we've done it every week in the world pretty much since then. And so we're thrilled to do it as a family. And so Andrea's homeschooled both of our boys and keeps everything running. We couldn't do it without her. We don't know these guys. We hired them off the internet this week to play for you. And they're doing a good job. These are our sons. Over there on the drums, that is Tyler. And Tyler is now 18 years old. So. It's crazy to think, but Tyler is a fantastic musician, and you're going to hear that all morning. He has wanted to move to Nashville since he was 3 days old, and we moved 2 years ago from Michigan to Nashville, Tennessee. And Tyler plays in the recording studios and on recordings, gospel recording sessions in Nashville with the very, very best musicians in the world, and it's really awesome to see. He started playing drums for us when he was six. Look at that. Isn't that amazing? I know. Isn't that cute? I don't know what happened. But anyways, he started playing with us when he was six. By the time he was eight, he was our full-time drummer. And Tyler's had some great opportunities. I don't know if you've heard of this guy or not. You know, some of you probably have if you followed the Gaithers a little bit. But one of the greatest tenor singers in the world is a guy named David Phelps. And Tyler has been out playing for him a little bit in the last year. And that's a pretty big honor. Would you welcome Tyler to Casa Grande? All right? Last but certainly not least, this is Trevor. He is 14, almost 15 years old. That's hard for us to believe. I don't want you to be fooled. This is a little public service announcement. Some of you already bought into his act, hook, line, and sinker. He's up here all serious. He isn't smiling. He's playing. He's kind of bopping to the groove, you know. Don't buy it. That kid's not right. He's one of the funniest people in the world. Don't buy this serious act. He's crazy, all right? And Trevor started playing guitar for us when he was about 6 years old. And, I know, isn't that great? And he started singing with us when he was about three. Now, we're going to play a game in a little while. And when he sings, I'm going to tell you now, just so you know the game. We're going to play a game called, What Key Can Trevor Sing In Today? You see, a year ago, exactly a year ago, he sang higher than his mom. And then teenage hit, okay? And he has dropped his song that he's gonna sing today, one of them, we recorded in the key of G. G for Jesus, you know? Key of G. Today, we're not gonna do it G, we're gonna drop it. 7 steps down to the key of D flat, because that's where he's singing now. Would you welcome Trevor, all right? All right, we're gonna do a song now that if you've got seat belts on your seat, I'd like you to reach down and put them on, okay? This is our newest radio single. This was a top 25 song in all the nation for Christian music for us, and it was awesome for us. But we were out here last year on this trip, and we just recorded it. We were just getting ready to send it to radio, and I think not long after we left here, we went up to Las Vegas to do some concerts at the casinos, and some churches, yeah. Pastor, we tried to double the love offering. You know how it is. That's a joke. Just a little church joke. It's okay. We were up there singing. We had a couple days off, and we went camping out in this dry lake bed. It's like 30 square miles, and it's huge outside in Boulder City, Nevada, just outside of Las Vegas. And so while we were there, Tyler said, "Dad, let's film a music video." So he filmed this. He did all the camera work, set it up. He edited it. He did everything. This song gets up and moves a little bit. I love it. It says an important truth that you need to leave here in your heart with today. It says, God is good. Do you believe that?
Yeah.
Amen. All right, here we go. Nothing to break the wind. So we get all set up. Tyler had the drums in place, the piano in place. He had tape on the ground where Trevor was supposed to stand and play. Tape on the ground for his mom. He said, "We're going to shoot it four times. The camera in four different spots. I'll cut it all together, film the whole thing." We get ready to start, and we realize we had made a huge mistake. You see, what we do with most of our songs is on this laptop, there is what we call a click track. And so in Tyler's ear, when we start the song, I press the button, and in his ear it says, "God is good. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And the entire time he's playing, he hears click, 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 click. And that keeps you locked in time, locked into the instruments. And when you're doing a music video, I'll give you a secret.
we're not really playing. You know, I mean, we're playing, but you're not hearing it. It's pre-recorded, right? We're pantomiming. So we had to be able to hear that. Well, we set all that up behind the camera. And then we realized somebody was going to have to press that button, and that button was about where your back wall is. And Tyler had to beat the drums, Trevor had a heavy bass, she's dressed all pretty, has to stand in place. Somebody had to press the button and run, and it fell to me, and I don't know if you know this or not, but I'm not much of a runner. Would you like to see what that looked like? So right now, I just pressed the button. You're gonna see Tyler start playing. He's playing, I gotta get there, because I gotta sing. I gotta get there, 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 here, come, 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 come. Now you know. Yeah. Now that you've seen that, let me show you the actual video, and I want you to watch me just pop into the frame, all right? All right, here we go. All right, here's the actual video. Oh, man, are you ready to hear Trevor sing something for you?
Yeah. Well, we wanted to sing kind of a newer song, and we wanted some of you guys to sing it with us. But the problem is, it's a completely new song, so none of you guys know any of the words. So I'm going to really quickly teach you guys your part.
Okay.
It's a little bit complicated, but I'm sure you guys can handle it, right? Can you say na-na? One more time? And that is all you need to know. You guys are really quick learners, by the way. That's impressive.
Yeah, we need to get the right key. All right, good. the road.
Where's your new cup? Where's your new cup? You know what? Sure did.
Oh, okay.
Where's your cup? See ya!
We're just gonna do a couple more for you. I told you we've come to tell you two things, and that is that there's a Savior named Jesus. You know, I know Him as my personal Savior. There's not a doubt in my mind. Not a doubt in my mind. That if something happened to me today and I went out into eternity, that I would be with Jesus. Not because I've done anything good. Not because my parents knew Christ. Not because my grandparents did. But because I confessed my sin, and I believe that He died on the cross, and He rose again. Because that's what the Bible says. Confess your sin. He'll be faithful and just to forgive you and cleanse you from unrighteousness. The Bible says, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that He was raised from the dead, thou shalt be saved. He was perfect. He was sinless. And He gave His life when He didn't have to. And He suffered and bled and died to satisfy the wrath of a holy, righteous God. And that perfect blood that was sacrificed covered the sin of every man that ever would be. It's almost difficult to wrap our minds around that it's that simple. But Jesus did everything. We've come to tell you that. If you don't know Him as your Savior, we would beg you this morning, just even where you're seated, trust Him. The Bible just says confess your sin. That's not hard for most of us. To say, yeah, I've messed up a few times in my life. A few times a day. Sometimes. The Bible says, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. Believe that He died for you. Say, Lord, I believe You died for me. I believe You rose again. I want You to be my Savior. Please save me. It's that easy. The second thing we've come to tell you, and we've been singing it all morning, is that God is good. I bet if we pass this microphone around and says, share what's on your heart, share your burdens, share your fears, share your concerns. We'd be here the rest of the evening sharing those, some of the things that we're walking through. You want to know how I know that you're going through those things? Because we are too. It's been heavy lately in our house. Andrea's lost both of her parents in the last less than 2 years. And we've dealt with a ton of sickness. We were supposed to leave Wednesday morning at 9 a.m. We didn't leave till Thursday night because of heart tests and things going on. It's been crazy. But here's what I know. Even when I can't see Him working, I know He is. Because I know He's done it before, and He promised He'd never leave me. He'd never forsake me. The God of Gideon can do the impossible. The God of Gideon is unstoppable. God is good. We just sang it. We've been singing this all morning. So I love this song. I love what it says. We've come here to tell you whatever you're walking through, God is faithful, and you can trust Him because He is good. Amen. and we always make crowds. We always make crowds the promise that Elizabeth Taylor made her husbands. We won't keep you real long. So I figured you were the right crowd to understand that joke. I really did. This lady's like, yeah, we get it, yeah. Our time's about up, but we got a few minutes. But let me just say, maybe you've been in church your whole life, and that you're going, you know His promises are true, but you're walking through something difficult. God is good, and He's faithful. The Bible says, surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life. He said, I'll never leave you, I'll never forsake you. Cast your cares upon me because I care for you. Psalms 55:22 is my favorite verse. And that verse says, cast your burden upon the Lord and He will sustain thee. I'm thankful for that. Heavenly Father, I pray this morning that if there's someone here that doesn't know you as their Savior, maybe they've heard us sing about that rugged cross, and we've talked about your shed blood, and we've talked about our need for a Savior. Maybe there's someone here that would just say, you know what, I know about Jesus, but I've never actually asked Him to be my Savior. I've never confessed my sin to Him. I've never just said, Jesus, I need you and I believe in you. Save me. Lord, I pray that maybe right now you'd speak to their hearts and they would know this is the moment. No matter how young, no matter how old we are, it's a decision we all must come to. Heads are bowed and eyes are closed. I'm not gonna call anyone out. I just really want to pray for you with no one looking. If you're hearing, say, Mark, I need to trust Jesus, would you slip your hand up and just say, I need to trust Him this morning? Is there anyone at all? I see that hand. The Bible says, confess your sin and you'll be forgiven. You can do it like this. Jesus, I'm a sinner. And I need you. Jesus, I believe in you. And I'm asking you to save me. I believe you died and rose again. Make me your child. Wash me clean from my sin. In your name I pray. The Bible says if you do that, if you trust Him with a simple childlike faith, that He washes your sin debt clean through the blood that He shed. Your name is written in the book of life in heaven. God is your Father. You are His child, and you're set free from the bondage of sin. If you have questions about that, I'd ask you to come talk to us afterwards. But if you did that in this moment, we rejoice with you. And it's an exciting thing. If you trust Him right now, slip your hand back up and let me see. Did you do that? I see that. It's wonderful. Several this morning. Wonderful, wonderful. Lord, we thank you for these that have, you know, maybe just made sure, or maybe for the first time ever, just trusted you. And I pray you'd seal that in their hearts, that they would know that it's what you did on the cross that sets us free. We thank you for your mercy and your grace that's found for all of us that come to you humbly. We thank you for those that have met you this morning. In your name we pray. All God's people said. Amen. Tyler, would you play that song? That's wonderful to see some people trust Jesus. Thank you.
just touch on something. My brother Steven, how many of you were here when my brother Steven was here? All right. He was the one, he was the dummy. No, he was the guy with the dummies. You know what I'm saying? All right. That's my brother Steven. Yes, I know he's 6'4 and, you know, 38 pounds. He is my brother. But he probably told you a little bit about this, shared the ministry that we have in the nursing homes. And I want to give you a little update that maybe he didn't have all that information for. But if you don't know what I'm talking about, we have a ministry initiative that we call Project Always Remember. We go sing in nursing homes periodically throughout the year. When we have some time off or on a tour, we'll go sing in some nursing homes, and we love doing that. But there's 43,000 nursing homes, assisted living homes, and facilities in this country. 43,000. Every one of us probably has a relative or a loved one that has had to be in a facility like that at some point. And some of us are headed there, right? I know I am. I can't hardly walk now. I don't know what it's going to be in 40 years. But I want to go to a nice one. I want one that's got a pool and all that. We need to make some more money. We really do. So we started a ministry that called Project Always Remember. And what we did is we said, let's take a church service to every nursing home in America. So what we did, we went to a studio in Nashville. We filmed a one-hour church service with us and our instruments. We sang songs like The Old Rugged Cross, In the Garden, Amazing Grace, on and on and on. We read scripture like the 23rd Psalm. We gave the gospel like we did this morning so that they would, maybe for the last time, hear about Jesus and what he could do. And we said, let's mail that to all, let's make it onto a DVD, and let's mail that to 43,000 nursing homes, and they can have a church service. Then we discovered that was going to be over $600,000 to do. So we started with a couple hundred. 3 years ago, right exactly 3 years ago, we started this ministry, and as of this morning, we have sent it to 9,970 nursing homes across this country have received this ministry. It's been through we certainly budget for it, and we don't profit off that DVD. We don't sell that DVD. You can't come buy it from us. It's not for sale. It's a special thing we paid for and did. And but we fund it, but we also have people like you fund it. There's a jar on our table that people give to. Some people come up and use cards or checks or whatever. It's sometimes literally pennies at a time. And then there was a man in Missouri that walked up and gave us a $5,000 check and said, send as many as you can. I think we sent about 800 nursing homes that DVD with that. You say, does it do any good? I just got an email yesterday from one. They didn't really say where they were from, but it's somewhere that we had mailed it to, and they said, we love this. We've shown it to our people a couple times this week, and they said specifically that the person who comes in to do church has had to cancel recently, and so they had shown it two Sundays in a row as a church service. And so we got an email a while back that somebody said, they said, we got your DVD a week ago, or it was like 2 weeks ago. They said, we have shown it to our people 12 times. It's a memory care facility, and they think it's new every time they see it. So I just wanted to update you on that and how many we've done. Every Monday morning, we count. Stephen lets us know what he raised, how what we raised. We put that together. We're passionate about this. My grandma spent time in a nursing home, and when she sometimes couldn't remember us, she would remember Jesus. And so I'm thankful for that. So I just wanted to update you with that. It has been good to be with you. Thank you for letting us come and share our music and just be here and you know, sharing your Arizona dirt with me. And is it still on me? Oh, it was on that golf cart, so it was. I sat in that golf cart. I'd rather do that than walk. I appreciate it. There's a long ways. But I was like, why would they have dirt all over me? But anyways, we're going to do one final song. We've been singing this song for about 13 years. And a couple times we've tried to quit singing it. Because we thought, well, let's do something different. And people would always ask for it. And so we've realized we're going to sing this one for the rest of our career. And that's fine, because I think it's one of the greatest lyrics ever written. And we're working on a new record, and we thought if we're going to sing this forever, let's go ahead and re-record this, and let's record it with the style and the arrangement it deserves. So Tyler got together, and myself, we got together with four or five of the best musicians in Nashville. We recorded that, we arranged and recorded what you're about to hear. Then we sent it to a man who wrote the orchestration and got the orchestra involved. Then we sent it to North Carolina and we had a choir sing on it. And all because I think that this song is one that I know speaks to my heart every single time. I hope it will to yours as well. Listen.
Pretty thin.
Whoops. I just doing
you said. You said never get quiet.
Wow. And you thought they were loving. Three things. One, let's pray over them for their healing and transportation needs. Precious Lord, put your hedge around the foresters today, Lord. Keep them and keep them safe as they travel. Keep them healthy and whole, that they may bring the power of the message of God to many, many people this week, Lord. These next 2 weeks, in fact. We praise you, we love you, we glorify you in this place today. Lift them up, empower them, and strengthen them for their journey. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Two, you heard him say, believe on the name of Jesus Christ. That is completely different than believing in the name of Jesus Christ, because even Lucifer believes in Jesus. We don't want to be that low. We want to be above. Believe on Jesus for salvation. Amen?
Amen.
Three, gentlemen, if you'll come forward. You heard him say it was $1,000 plus to fuel to get up here. What he didn't say is it's also $1,000 plus to get home, not to mention driving around. God has been incredibly generous to us. Amen?
Amen.
Let us do so, because a worker is worth his wages. Hallelujah. Precious Lord, we ask that you bless this offering. Make it more than we could ever hope or ask, because that is what you tell us to do. To lean in unto you, to lean on you, to let you carry us, that we might carry them. So Lord, as we give today, we ask for generous hearts and generous wallets. Help us, Lord, to show them the appreciation that we have for their message, for their talents, for their hard work, frankly. For you are worthy. It's you they're praising, you they're adoring. And it's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.
Tell you about a couple things and then we're finished. If you would stop by the table in the back and pick up, we have a little free thing for you. We have a new picture of our family, and we just got these in, and so these are free if you will pray for us. All right, if you're not going to pray for us, that's $400. So on the back of that card is our QR code. You can scan that with your phone. It'll take you to our Facebook, Instagram, our websites. You can connect with us that way. And some of you were connected with that way, and we'd love to just connect with you more. You can follow where we're at, all the crazy things we get through. Like the one time in South Carolina a few months ago, when we went through 3 tires in 24 hours. You can read about that on Facebook if you follow us, all right? So you can do that. If you stream your music, we are in all the streaming services, and you can find us anywhere, like YouTube or Apple Music or any of that. If that's how you listen to music, you can find us. We'd love for you to do that. Now, it's much better for us if you take home some physical media. And so we have 4 different types of media. We have 4 different CDs, all right? A brand new one's called a worship record. It's a worship record. We sang off of it this morning. All the songs we sang today, I think except one, are on a CD, all right? And so we have 4 of those. Now, we have other types of media. So you may say, well, I don't have a CD player anymore. Well, that's okay. We have a DVD if you have a DVD player. That's an hour and 10-minute concert you can watch. And it's really good, and it's really well filmed and everything. We have a vinyl record, if you can believe that. Records got popular again, so we had some made. They're almost gone. We only have a few left, but we have a record. So CDs, DVDs, USB, or vinyl. If you don't have any of that, we have a USB stick. She's got one there, and that you can put that in your car, in that little USB slot in your car, or if you've got a computer, plug in your car, press play. There's 7 complete albums on that thing. You can. We had a guy in Michigan come up to us, and he said, I took that USB, and I drove from Detroit, Michigan to San Diego, California, and that's all I listened to all the way there and all the way back. And then he goes, what do you think about that? And I said, even my mother doesn't like our music that much, you know. But that USB drive is a great way to listen to music in this day and age. If you don't know how to use that, go ahead and buy it this morning. Trevor will come home with you this afternoon. He'll teach you how, and you can bring him to our concert at 4 o'clock this afternoon in Sun City. So that's what we have. We have 2 T-shirts. One says "It Is Well with My Soul," and it has our logo on it, the Foresters. And the other one, I love this. It says, "All my life, He's been faithful. God is good." And that's what we've sung all morning. So those things, they help us. They help us take care of things. I was at the gas station last night. I looked at one of my tires and went, uh-oh. And so it's just, you know, it's just what happens on the road. And it's you people are so gracious around the country to keep us rolling and to go tell people about Jesus. The final thing I'll show you is we have this bag that has everything in it. And for any gift of $60 or more, you get 4 CDs, a DVD, a T-shirt, a USB, and a record. You get all of that in that bag. You really ought to be more excited than you are right now. But it's a pretty good deal. And 60, I've forgotten now, I used to know the math, but $60 sends us, I don't know, it's like 125 miles. So I don't know what it is. No, it's more than that. But it's a couple hundred miles. So it helps us out, all right? So we have that. And then if you want to be a part of the nursing home ministry, you can see Andrea in the back. Listen, isn't that great? We love this ministry. It's important. And so we're excited about that. And the final thing, there's some people here, Andrea, who support us monthly. I was talking to one of them earlier. Just listen, we have never charged anyone to sing. Most gospel groups do. And that's fine. I understand why they do. But we just decided any church, anytime, anywhere, we'll go. All right? Let God figure out how to pay for it. He owns the cattle on 1,000 hills, right? Sometimes you got to ask him to sell one, you know. So one of the ways that we're able to do that is we have people who support us monthly. And you say, well, what does that mean? There's a lady in Ann Arbor, Michigan, for 23 and a half years has sent $5 a month. And she has never missed a month in 23 years. And so we have about 160 people who do things like that. One person does 4. Some people do large amounts. But all of it, in a pile together, takes care of the needs on the road. And so we're honestly praying. We're praying for several hundred more who would do $5 or $10 a month and help us just bridge that gap. I know you know costs are up. And if you can't, that's fine. Take that picture and pray for us, because God can put the right people in the right place, but we need the prayers. But if you're interested in that, this card will tell you how to fill out. You can fill that card out today and give it to Andrea. We'll sign you up, or you can take it home and mail it. You can take it home and do it on our website. But we'd love for a couple of you to pray about doing that and just help us make a difference and see some more people trust Jesus as their Savior. Amen? Amen. You want me just to, you got something to say?
Maybe one more?
Sure. We'll do something here. What? What are we going to do? Anybody got something you want to hear? That'd be hard to sing. Let me see if I can do this with it. Something out of the hat like he used to. I'll tell you what, let's maybe one more. Somebody got his favorite.
I can only imagine.
Yeah, we couldn't do that and do it justice. Grace.
Only if you'll sing it with me. All right, let's do it.
One more thing I would like to ask, can I have one of those DVDs, the one that you sent to the memory care?
We can get one.
Because I could show that every Sunday and everybody would forget anyway that they've seen it.
They didn't boo when I said that, but I booed when you said that.
Thank you, Rick, for that little encouragement on my part. Thank you for coming today, and may the God of love and peace and joy go with you today and share some of the things that you heard today to others that didn't make it today. Amen?
Amen.
You're dismissed.